Greetings, fellow Oathlings. Welcome back to the Elder Scrolls 2 Daggerfall. We are playing as Mage in Unity, and, I actually searched a few things online. The game might seem brighter to you, and that is because, well, as it turns out, posterization or palletization in retro mode, which you can actually access through here, effect settings, I turned it on to make it look a little more retro for this playthrough. Turns out, turning this on will actually make the game appear... How do I put this? This is like what it originally should look like. These are again like the textures only look like this because of vanilla enhanced edition. So yeah, this is what a very low resolution would look like, and this is a slightly higher resolution. I think compared to the two, this one looks better for whatever reason. So I guess I'm just gonna stick with this. Anyhow, so palletization actually makes the dark areas too dark, and so does posterization. So the fix to that is either turning this off entirely or turning on color boost, which I have, which sort of makes darkness inside dungeons pointless. Now, the other thing that I discovered is the fact that this game is actually more difficult than the DOSBox version of Daggerfall, because the enemies now use the weapons that are in their inventory, and that makes them hit way harder. So no wonder I've been getting totaled inside of dungeons. So basically, yeah, we'll have to grind up a lot, not just like our skills, but also our gear. So basically, the objective for today's video is essentially to raid the minor crypts so that we can get some semblance of gold and buy something worthwhile for ourselves. Look at all those birdies. That's nice. Anyhow, so as I was saying, let us go ahead and travel to some nearby crypt then. Like, minor dungeon. So, as you can see, there are like a lot of minor dungeons available all around. This is like a... yeah, that is one of the only dungeons that we have that is not a minor dungeon. Now, Daggerfall is full of them, like the entire Illiac Bay is full of them, but because of the persistent dungeons mod that I've installed... yeah. Okay, time to equip ourselves, and let us go and raid these dungeons here, wherever the door is. So these are typically supposed to be smaller than full-scale dungeons, at least as far as I know. Okay, not an interest there. We need to find it. But because of the persistent dungeon spawn, once I clear out a dungeon, it will remain cleared. And, well, that's something though. These are all cemeteries, from the looks of it. That might be an entrance, who knows? Yep, Gearheart Vault. I thought this was the Yomston Cemetery. Anyhow, let's... go in, I suppose. Should be a minor dungeon unless this is like one of those bigger dungeons. So, yeah. So once I clear out a dungeon... seems straightforward enough for now. So the thing is, once I clear out a dungeon... I'm just resting to let my magicka go, and that's literally it. So once I clear out a dungeon, it will remain cleared out for eternity. Like, if I ever choose to go back there, the enemies won't spawn back in again. Okay, I see some loot. Oh, short tunic and potion recipe. What potion is this? Cure poison. Oh, holy hell, that is important. I'm not saving it because I have not encountered any battles thus far. So in these dungeons, all I can expect are stuff like bats. So these guys don't hit remotely as hard because of the simple fact that that's a zombie in there in a summoning circle. That is not a good sign, but I'll just go ahead and rest here until I'm healed. I'm healed, let us go ahead and save the game here. Yeah, let us use the save, why not? Okay, so yeah, I can't exactly visit the same dungeon twice. So if this game becomes too... like, if I run out of dungeons in this game by the time that I'm done leveling up, I'll just go ahead and Open tunic. Yeah, this seems fashionable actually. Maybe we can try equipping that. Yeah, we can't really change the look of that thing though. So we have covered all three doors here. Let's just take a quick look and see if there are any hidden doors or something here. There seems to be a... yeah, there's just a coffin in the middle there. Same here. Let me just switch to this view, I'm more comfortable with that view. Alright, I don't think there are any hidden doors. Typically, if there are hidden doors, this game will... oh, there is a hidden door. Right there. Right there. Alright, let's go back then. So, this is one of the benefits of having... actually, let me go ahead and equip my staff instead. I would like to increase my blunt weapon. So I primarily plan on using this instead of any other weapons. Red berries, southern red berries, alright. Iron longbow. I do not plan on using any bows. Now, these boxes were also meant to be lootable, but I guess the developer of Daggerfall did not exactly want that. Why is there like a void right there underneath that box? Curious. Can't be pushed. I guess that's just their way of blocking off the entrance there. So yeah, that gave us a bit of gold, and that's pretty much it. I suppose there's nothing else to this dungeon, as far as I can tell. And that's pretty much it. So yeah, this video will be about all of these minor dungeons, and we'll go around and raid them to the best of our ability. Let me go ahead and save the game here. Let us hope that we are healthy, because I do not have a potion for cure disease. Diseases can be cured by people from the Mage's Guild though, so I'm not terribly concerned about that. Okay, that's where I am. Alright, I thought I went here, Yomson Cemetery. Anyhow, let's go get them. You smell fresh turned earth, white flowers lit the path. Alright. So yeah, if a point at all comes where I still need to level up by raiding these tiny dungeons, and I can't manage to do that because I've run out of them, I'll just go ahead and reset that mod. Like, install a timer and then reinstall. Like, you can set it, like, you can set the persistence level. It doesn't have to be, like, dungeons don't have to be persistent all the time. You can set it to, like, forget or reset the dungeon every 12 days or so. Alright, let's go, let's save here. Just in case there are, like, really powerful creatures in there. You never know, right? So I'll rest here until I gain my magicka back. And once that is done, we shall begin exploring. Layout seems quite similar. Oh. Janbad died, that is good. Two doors here. Nothing behind door number one from the looks of it. Any false areas on the map? Like any false doors on the map? 130 gold pieces, that is amazing. So I'm also using this mod called Realistic or Modern Loot, which enables me to... essentially just loot without having to open up the loot menu. Alright, your turn now. I don't have the spell points right now. Giant Scorpion Stinger and Unicorn Horn, that is great. I do have a wagon, don't I? I could probably use it to, you know. Are there any hidden doors in this dungeon then? None that I can see. Any hidden door at the very end there? There's only like a bookshelf there which we cannot really interact with inside dungeons anyway. We can only like steal from people's possessions when it comes to these boxes, but not near the hidden doors. So this is pretty much the only level of challenge that my character is capable of right now in this game at least. If this was the original Daggerfall, I probably could have gone and raided any of the major dungeons, but as far as this game is concerned, Daggerfall Unity, with the changes it makes, I'm not able to do any of that. So the problem with the persistent dungeon mod is the fact that, well, our magic is regenerating, which is a good thing. So the problem with the persistent dungeons mod is that, there's that. We are healthy. Might as well save here. Because why not? I'll use this to save in front of fresh dungeons. We could just camp out, but I do not want to chance an encounter with orcs. That would be bad indeed. Being the entire reason why I'm choosing to travel cautiously instead. So, as we have already established, there's nothing over there. That's sort of like a shrine of sorts. These are really interesting layouts. I just wish even mainline dungeons would be this interesting. The layouts, I mean, because as far as mainline, there are enemies nearby. Okay. Somebody opened a door there. Or maybe that was just a sound. Oh no. Rat just died. Okay, wait, let me just go ahead and equip the torch here so that I can see better in the darkness. I should have done this like a long time ago. You know what? Yeah. Let me go ahead and bind this to slot 7. Right. It'll be easier that way. I see a healthy thief. Healthy thief, huh? A healthy thief of all things. I would like to switch over to that instead. So that I can hit harder. I did not expect a thief here. Ooh, we got him. Left wall drone. Yeah, chain cuirass. Leather boots. So let's see what we have here. Oh wait, we already have like chain boots, so we don't really need that. Armor and weapons right here. Leather left wall drone, let us go ahead and equip that. And chain cuirass. Leather boots, let us go ahead and put that back on the ground. And here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go all the way back to the entrance. And this time I'm gonna dress properly. Oh yeah, there are enemies nearby. I don't know how. Maybe there's like a secret entrance right near the door there somehow. Taking cobwebs line the wall. Let us go ahead and save in celebration of being able to take that guy out. A first human enemy. Actually, not a first human enemy. Somehow the human enemies in this game are easier to eliminate. Like, how many hits do you take, son? You took like a lot of hits there. Drain Mentor Magical Pool is what you did. Do I have... No, I'm healthy. Which is strange because I did mention that I've got like a low tolerance to... That's a dead rat. Roadkill. If you wanna dignify it that way. Okay, let's check the cell mount. Should have hit the F6 key instead. Plus 3. Actually, I'll go ahead and equip this because this seems just a tad better. So I'll drop that to the ground because, well, I honestly don't need it. Spider's venom and black poppy. Useful essential ingredients there. Nothing else here. Not from the looks of it anyway. Are there any hidden tools in this room? None that the eye can see. There's seemingly something. Oh no, that was blocked up by a piece of furniture. Nothing down here, but I did hear like rats and stuff up there. So that beckons the question, is there like a hidden door somewhere along this route then? Because of the way that the graphics are better, it's actually more difficult to see hidden doors in this game. Ah, okay. Wait, what? Oh, I guess I must have picked everything up from that then. Unless... Whoops. Nah. I guess there's nothing else here then. Just this. I hear rats. I hear rats. Which beckons the question, where's the damn thing? Like, how is it right beside me? I like this vertical feature because it actually lets me know exactly where everything is. No hidden doors there, no hidden doors here. This really makes like a ton of quality of life changes to Daggerfall. These changes. Look, there's a sound of the rat again. Where is it? It says there are enemies nearby, but I can't see any. Anyhow. I'm going crazy right now. Let me switch that off, and I don't want to attract unwanted attention being out here right now. I could probably keep this inside. Maybe let's keep the change of clothes in there. And potion recipe, we can keep it on us, doesn't really hurt. Let's keep all our ingredients in there. We definitely don't need any ingredients where we're headed right now. So this one next up? Master Sleep Vaults. Alright, let's go. A crow calls in the distance. Wagon ruts lead off a base. So much gold do we have right now? 874, not a whole lot of gold either. But yeah, I do want some gold so that I can afford better armor for one, and the other purpose of grinding up this much is to... Interesting. Yeah, I was just looking at the bird and all the banding around it. I don't know if banding is the right word, but like, there was like this weird orb around it as it was flying through the sky. But yeah, I do want to make some powerful custom spells, and yeah, that's pretty much it. So there's somebody's home in here, which is strange. Let's bash this open. This house is nothing of value, of course. So we did finally manage to get it open, but the house had nothing of value, is what happened. Okay, not there. Let me try to not step on anybody's graves there, because that would be bad, I feel like. Anyhow, here we are, Master Sleep Vaults. Dungeon safe, right. Excuse me there. I like this dungeon theme music, to be honest. Enemies nearby, let us hope it is not under one of those humans. You know, I really thought I had like difficulty staying alert and awake. It's just a rat, but let us go ahead and shock you to death. A healthy rat, hungry. Are you dead yet? How many hits would it take to kill you, sir? I thought I heard something open back there. The rat doesn't know where I am any longer. How did the rat manage to hit me from all the way there? Interesting question. But let us just rest here until we're totally healed. And save in save 2, was it? Or was it save 1? It was save 1. Alright, let us go ahead and loop. Nothing in here. Leather left pauldron, we already have that. I mean, I could probably sell it, but it's just leather, it really won't fetch all too much. Holy shit! Are there two humans in there? Okay, no way are we ever going to... Okay, we need to run. And when I say run, I mean run. Oh, there you are. Hmm. So the good thing is, we can probably rest here. And get back inside the dungeon. Ooh, that looks lovely. The rising sun, I mean. So where's the rat again? I have no idea. He's finally dead. Steel mace. Chain purse. I don't have the spell points for that. Oh yeah, I just came in, didn't I? Good thing is, if this gets too difficult... Whew. I am doing better than before, that is for certain. Chain Rat Baldrock, let's go ahead and get that. Leather greaves, leather boots. We do need some greaves, so maybe. We have a hell. There are scratches on the floor, of course. Because Chain Quiris. Let's see. Let us compare ingredients, right? Let us go in there amazing, but of course there are. There's probably a rat in there. But leather greaves, let us go ahead and equip that. And helm. +3, +3. Which one do we find most stylish? Is the question. This one? This one? This one? This one. Chain quiver is probably the same. +6, +6. Alright. I do want to put stuff into my wagon, and it's nice that it actually automatically selects the wagon for you instead of letting you just drop stuff onto the ground, unlike in Daggerfall. Because that thing was a menace. Alright. A dead thief. So this thing really is overpowered. The ebony blade, I mean, in real life. We are healthy, which is all I need to know. Literally all I need to know. There's some loot here, 100 gold pieces, and a short skirt which I've got no use for. It won't really sell for any amount of money either. Anything here? Nope. Alright. To the other door now. Anyhow. Anything here? Nope, nothing. I wonder if these were guards. No, they were just literally grave robbers, is what they were. I'm glad to know that I can actually, even though I have to resort to using tricks, but I still can go ahead and take on human enemies. That is something very empowering to know. Anyhow. Are we healthy? Yes, we are. I have to keep checking. Not that. Let us then go ahead to this one, Buckingham Cemetery. I should probably turn the torch off when I'm outside, especially. I mean, that's mostly for role-playing purposes. This game does not exactly have a system where is the entrance. Looks like we're gonna have to find it the old-fashioned way. So this game doesn't exactly have a system. Okay, this is some creepy music. Especially with the bass kicking in like that. Is that Master or is that Secunda? I never really know. Or is it Secunda? Who knows? Who knows? They didn't exactly provide a phonetical pronunciation guide with their game. These guys, I mean. So this is probably the door. Yes, it is. Alright, let us save in front of the dungeon here. And if things get too difficult, we'll come outside and... So I already know what's gonna happen here because... Well, I already cleared like a section of this game before I... essentially... My game crashed. There's gonna be a bandit behind this door. Yep, right there. On cue. Ooh, that was impressive. I did not expect my shock spell to be that effective, but it was. That is really impressive, really. Yeah, Elven Saber, that might actually sell for some. simple stuff that is going to be useful for us. So let us go ahead and iron staff instead of this. Let us go ahead and reassign this to hotkey 3. And I'm just gonna hold on to this for now, regardless. Come here then. This thing died. Cool. Let me just rest up again and heal up. Even these dungeons are taking me a long time. I'm healthy. I'll just go ahead and save the game right here. So, I don't know why it happened, but my game crashed. Which is not something that I was expecting from Daggerfall Unity, but I guess even though it is the 1.0 release, it's not exactly the most stable, so to speak. Holy water is good. I could have just given the holy water to that woman instead of stealing it. Nothing else, just two doors and that's it. There's literally nothing else here. I mean, I hear some scary stuff in the background, but I just hear it. I mean, I have no way of verifying whether it's actually there or not. From the looks of it, there is nothing here. I like how there's like a pivot point now around which you can rotate the map. I guess that's it. This was like a tiny dungeon. Nothing else here. Let me go ahead and update the save. I hear some objectionable stuff in the background and I do not want to go there. Wherever that is. Interesting. Overcast weather. We're here, so maybe we travel to this dungeon here. Graves of Buckingham. Alright, let's go. I wonder if I have gold and one day to travel there. Interesting. Oh yeah, let me turn this off. The torch. Excuse me, though. That seems to be the entrance, but the crypt that I'm interested in is right outside. So let me go and save here again, as is customary. Enemies nearby, which is... It's like the rat drops from the corner of the ceiling or something, which I've always found to be very strange. I am blending. There is a rat there. The rat is dead. My abilities seem to have become better. Priest robes. Maybe we could try it on for size, who knows. Oh, these come on top of your armor. That is interesting. Really interesting. We got some holy water as well, but I don't really know what this does. Maybe we could sell it at, I don't know. Let's go ahead and save the game here because I hear some scary stuff in the background. Anything here? Nothing? Cool. Thought I might find somebody like you here. Okay, we need to keep running. Holy shit. Did we almost die there? Nope. I'm resting out here. There's another thief back there. Holy shit, this is brutal dungeon. Three thieves of all things. Okay, we are saving the game here. Thank God for... Actually, thank the creator of Persistent Vengeance for creating it. How does it feel to taste death? Huh? Does it feel good? I probably should have taken... buckler. definitely. And a chain left pauldron. Let's go. Let's equip the buckler and the chain left pauldron. And yeah, we'll keep that in our inventory for later. I'm healed. It's good. What does this guy have? 22 gold pieces. Elven claymore, that's gonna sell. Silver boots. Let's wait a minute. I cannot wear these, but I can probably sell them, so that's fine. Plus 3? Yeah, I don't know. I'll just collect loot until I cannot collect anymore. 148 gold pieces. Anything else here? Nothing on the doors, I suppose. Even my own footsteps echoing on the walls is sort of giving me a creepy vibe, and I would say that's basically just good game design. That is how this game should be. It should creep you out. Especially the dungeon diving part. Like, I am currently using some exploits made possible because of... Interesting, where's the other guy? Let us go ahead and put... Ooh, there's a giant bat right here. I don't have the spell points. Why is that? Why do I not have spell points right now? Let us go ahead and put some stuff in our wagon here. Such as the silver claymore and this elven saber. Silver iron stuff and this and this and... You definitely... Yeah, your class prohibits you from equipping this. Good, good, good. Alrighty then. Am I healthy? I'm healthy. Alright, we travel next to this here dungeon, or maybe it was this one. I think we have not been here yet. So let us go here. Let us go here first and then we'll decide what to do next. Okay, the entrance is right here, which is good. I keep forgetting to turn the torch off. I hope it does not burn out at one point in time, because that would be bad. It's strange how these all seem so shallow from the outside, but they're pretty deep on the inside. Alright. Actually, let's rest here until we restore our magicka. What's strange to me though is the fact that this one actually goes straight down. Holy shit, bruh. Okay, looks like I did some damage there. Steel mace, steel claymore, definitely. Steel cuirass, little greaves. How do you have all of that? Enemies nearby. Alright, let's go back here and rest right here. In the corner like a good little boy. Ah, you. Come here. Alright. Cool, let us go ahead and save the game here. What's strange to me is the fact that I am constantly facing human enemies now. As if it's this some kind of a trend going on all of a sudden. Did you have armor class or did I just fail to connect and hit the wall instead? Because that sounded like a clunk. Nothing is supposed to clunk with you. Alright, this was a pretty small dungeon. Let's go back to the top then. And wait, what? I thought I saw a figure there. Nah, I'm gonna get out. Right, let's turn that off and let us hail to the next dungeon, which I think was this one right here. The Vixley Burial Ground. A low, ghostly moon shivers by, little white flowers litter the path. We've spawned pretty far away from the dungeon this time around, I feel like. There's even like a moat and everything to probably ward off potential intruders. Those are the gates, by the way, the gates to the dungeon. What is this? Why is this place in ruins? I hope it is not a major dungeon, because it certainly feels like it, the vibes around it. I guess all of these pieces are well maintained because people keep coming here to maintain them. Yeah. Alright, let's get a spell points up so that we can practice some of our destruction and illusion spells. Destruction only for now. No illusion. Or maybe let's go ahead and cast it just for the shitty tables. Okay, there should be a human enemy in here. Like, if there is a human enemy in here, it's definitely right here. I heard the other door open there. I don't know if it was actually the door opening. No, it wasn't. Or just the sound effect built into the soundtrack itself. Okay, so these are the victims, just littered all over the ground. Not even buried properly. I don't know why they even bother. It's good to finally raid a dungeon that has no human enemies inside. Time to switch this off and let us go to... Where shall we go? This one? We haven't been here yet. Coppersmith graveyard. Alright, let's go. 5 gold and 1 travel time. I have a mark by this point in time. Alright. Let me check. I am healthy. Yes, that is a good sign. This place looks serene. Seems like the rear end of this dungeon. It even has like multiple entrances. I like this place. I like this place. Might not be a bad place to get buried. That's like talking about ominous things right before you do something bad or risky. Just getting a spell points up there. What was that? Don't tell me there's something like a mage in here. I stand no chance of going toe to toe with mages at this point in time. I just realized that I do need to use these spells if I want to. Arrow, I've got no use for those. For arrows, I mean. I do need to use the rest of my abilities as well if I want to level up. So maybe I should. Chain boots, gold pieces, chain boots. Alright, chain boots. Do we have chain boots already? Yes, we do. So we could probably keep this in the wagon. Steel mace, that's good. I could probably use steel mace as well because, 1 to 8 points of damage, 1 to 12 points of damage, of course. The staff is honestly like a very poor choice for a weapon, but I sort of wanted to go for a specific build. If it wasn't for what I have in my hands right now, the ebony blade, I probably would have screwed myself over with this build, especially when it comes to Daggerfall Unity. So I'm going to just keep spamming the spell as well. Maybe I should only do that once. I keep seeing figures over there. Alright, let's turn that off, and we are headed next to this one right here, the Crypts of Vicfield. Excuse me there. So that is most likely not the entrance. Neither is that. That is the entrance. Into the dungeon proper, I mean. Yes, it is. There's even like a lantern and everything here. What other spells did I have again? I still haven't figured out how to like properly cast spells in this game. Oh wait. Use, right. Heal. Oh, I've got a healing spell. That's interesting. I did not know that. Probably because of the color of the spell there. But at any rate, let us go ahead and make a save here. As is procedure. And that's literally all it is. Literally just procedure. is the only reason that we're making the saves here. Alright? This dungeon has a weird glow to it, like a greenish yellow glow. Let us go ahead and keep casting Chameleon. Like, the thing about Chameleon spell is that it cancels out as soon as you attack. But it is leveling up my... Oh, did not see you there. For whatever reason, these rats can see through our Chameleon spell. Maybe it's because we're wearing all this heavy chain boot and these creatures mostly rely on sound. Also use like a healing spell. Gold pieces, short shirt, sure. Anything for style, holy relic, anticlear, surcoat, potion of resist frost. That could be useful later on. Let us check out our new dapper looks. Ooh, this looks nice. But I think I'll stick with this because this looks better for the time being. Actually, you know what? Let us just go ahead and equip this. Yeah. Alright, so that's it. Is there any, are there any hidden doors or something? Over here. None that I can see. None that the eye can see. Yeah, pretty small dungeon. In fact, it was only the first dungeon that I went into that actually had a surprisingly hidden door. Like, I was surprised to see the fact that there are hidden doors inside of these smaller dungeons, and I was like, whoa, that's amazing, man. I'm just spamming these spells for the sake of spamming them. I don't really need to spam them. Actually, with that in mind, let us go ahead and transfer some of our loot onto our wagon. The heavier stuff especially, because these arrows, we don't really need them. Silver stuff, we might switch over to it later on especially. For now, let us travel to this one right here, the Ashford Graveyard. My goal is practically to tour all of this before calling it quits. Now, I do want to eventually go back to Privateer's Hold, but that will be at a point in time when I can take on skeletons easily, because those are practically the only enemies left in there at this point. I have been there previously to practice my long blade, and yeah, it works. The Ashford Graveyard. A low ghostly something, fresh buried trail. The entrance is pretty convenient right next door. What's up with that creepy music again? The music in this game is on point. Which is something I'll say. Okay, let's rest until we have reached full stamina, sorry, full magicka. And let us spam some spells just for the heck of it. Maybe it's because of the light that I'm toting over my head that these guys can easily tell where I am. Okay, our illusion skill has also upgraded, meaning that we should probably be able to... You know what? Ooh, this looks nice! Silver staff. Amazing. I don't know if somebody opened a door or... that was just a background sound. Oh, bat. The bat just died. This staff is actually pretty powerful as well. Oh, I suppose I must have made like a critical strike there. So there are some sounds that are just built into dungeons. Such as the sound of that mummy wrapping small tooth. Yeah, not those sounds, potion recipe. I don't know what potion that is, but it'll be useful to us anyway, later on, I mean. Okay, no hidden doors here, which is good, so that was pretty much it for this dungeon. Yeah, so that sound, for example, and the sound of something groaning and growling in the background here. Those are pretty much sounds that are built into the dungeon itself. I'm just casting the spell so that I can level up faster. That's literally it. Oh, I totally forgot to turn this on. Alright, where are we headed next then? Wait, I don't know if I want to save here. Continue. Oh, sorry. So which dungeon next is the question. So we have not really covered all of these dungeons. Vixley Burial Ground. I think we have covered that, but these two are yet uncovered. Gearham Graveyard, Hearthheart Graveyard, and what is this again? Cobblestone Vaults. So yeah, we'll procedurally cover each and every single one of those dungeons, gain as much money as we can. So let us go ahead and travel till there first. And yeah. Wait, how do I get in? This door is like closed. It looks like I'm gonna have to find another way in. I was not exactly expecting that door to be closed like that. Interesting to see that it is, and this piece has no other entry points thus far. I wonder what that is, like which of the moons that is, because Nirn is supposed to be... Ooh, I can finally level up and running now. I don't think there is a way in except for whatever is over there. Can I climb over it? Huh, good. Gave me a bit of trouble though. But at any rate, let us go ahead and make a save first. And with that having been done... Yeah, so with that having been done, I have an early morning tomorrow, so this is where I call it quits. But for you guys, it'll just be a transition. So when I come back, we'll continue hunting vaults. So see you guys then. Alright, so we're back, and there's a human enemy inside that I'm dying to. So we pretty much need to be careful. I think that was like a trap of some sort. Like a... Yeah, she's right around the corner right here. Come here. Where the fuck do you think you're shooting, bitch? I see. This thing is OPAD. This thing's like totally OPAD. You don't really need the chain boots. I'll just go up here and rest for a while. Get some health points up. And save you. This thing is totally OPAD. I mean, sorry, I don't know if I caught that or not, so I'm just gonna repeat that. This thing here is totally OPAD because the previous time around I was trying to get to that human. Potion of resist poison, that's nice. Maybe I'll pop that in for the next playthrough, who knows. I'm healthy. Excuse me there. Sorry, I had to sneeze there. I'm just spamming spells to erase my magic as well. No other reason why. And there are no more hidden tools or anything of that sort here either. Or in the other room. So yeah, it'd be cool. Let's go back then. So I've been trying to kill her even the previous run through, but I just could not manage to do that. And the primary reason was because I... it's morning again. Interesting. Why is my stamina not depleting though? Oh, it just doesn't show up that way, I suppose. I'll try and stick to this as much as I can, but if required, I'll be switching over to the Ebony Dagger whenever I see a human enemy. Alright, oh, not this one. Let's go to the next one then. And we're here, this one, I'm not certain whether we have raided this one yet. I don't think we have. This one I think we have raided. Yes, we have raided this, but these two we have not raided yet. So I guess we might as well make a quick work of them while we can. This, pretty sure we have already been there. Yeah, we have been to these two. Alright, next one. Alright. So I've been trying to hit her with the silver staff, and I landed quite a few good hits on her, but I just couldn't manage to kill her. Now the reason probably is the fact that the silver staff does only 1 to 8 points of damage, and this thing 5 to 10 points. So you've got like a better chance of success with the ebony dagger. It's almost new because I've used it so much. Might as well just drop this to the ground. I don't know why I still have it on me. Let's keep this in the wagon. I'm keeping a lot of things in the wagon, actually. That seems to be the entrance there. I guess the reason that enemies can hear me, even though I'm in the chameleon mode, is probably because... Right. It's probably... Wait, I can press here, right? Oh, of course, there are enemies nearby. There's like usually one random rat somewhere right next to the entrance. I should rest on what I've learned about stealth. How am I missing the rat? It's a damn rat! How many swings will this thing take? These things scamper all over the place. Maybe I should turn off the advanced enemy AI for a second there. Alright. Yeah. Blending. Wait, let me go ahead and save you. Just in case, you know. Yeah. Does not seem to be anything here. Cast it again. Interesting. I've never come across a locked door in the one of these dungeons before. That's a bat. And this thing is kiting, which is amazing actually. Look at this, it's taking so many hits just to kill this thing. Any hidden doors? None that I can see. Alright. Two gold pieces, that's it. This dungeon was a waste of time, but oh well. Maybe I could have used some of my other spells instead. Spamming spells. Because I'm not really going to get a chance to spam them again. Alright, back to Daggerfall. It's the middle of the night. Okay, time to turn this light off. Oh shit. And way to now, should we go all the way here then? Vixley graveyard, and right next to it is the Woodwing graveyard. Shall we start traveling this way? Because we have already cleared these dungeons. Or maybe we can continue on... Herthard and Geirham. I don't think we've been to Geirham yet. So let us go there. Let's go to Geirham and then we'll go offwards. Encompass the rest in the upper... in the return journey. Alright. I think that is where we have to go. This thing is out in the middle of nowhere, really. Very strange. Very strange, indeed. Curious. Oh, here's the entrance. Alright, saving you. Always better to save outside of a dungeon in this game. Alright, let's head in. Enemies nearby, of course, we cannot rest. Just to be wary of any sneak attacks. This game has you peeking around corners every time you run dungeons. And I feel like that's a very good way of representing dungeon crawls. I have half a mind to just switch back to the original format of enemies nearby. Still can't rest at this point in time. But I should save here. I'm healthy, right? Yeah. Another bat! That just flew in from around the corner. It's almost like an FPS game. And you can't miss the enemies quite a lot. That was a crit strike. So even that has upgraded at this point in time. Let's go ahead and update the save. So there are no such monsters in this dungeon. The kind of which you can hear all over the place. But Yeah, nothing here. 64 gold pieces, and how much do you have? 3 gold pieces and a vest. The question is, what does the vest look like? Short shirt, where's the vest? Resist frost, resist poison. Ah, not for me. It's for women. But oh well, that's fine. So these dungeons don't really have like a whole bunch of loot. Like the amount of loot present here is pretty, well, tiny. You don't really get a lot of loot from these dungeons. Excuse me. I'm trying to look at this room here, just to ensure that there were no hidden doors. Nah, there weren't any. Because I heard something opening and closing on the other side. A kind of sound that I've never heard before. Or the kind that has never been used for rooms inside dungeons until now. Vixleys, we have cleared them out. Alright, let's go to Woodcroft Burial Ground. 10 gold. Maybe it's because we're choosing to stay at inns versus just camping out, is why it costs us so much. Time to go for a swim. And one of the only reasons that we're not sinking to the bottom is either because this thing is not deep enough, or the fact that we're not wearing plate. Because if you're wearing plate, no matter how good of a swimmer you are, you will drown to the bottom every single time. And that's like just one of the ways that Daggerfall has been designed. Alright, time to save here. Actually, dungeon. Yeah. Excuse me there. Okay, we can rest here. That might or might not be a good sign depending on who you ask. Straight down. This dungeon looks nice. The walls in this dungeon look really nice. Hi there. Didn't see you there. But since I have spell points, might as well utilize them. Okay. I was planting. There are like two of these bats here. Why am I missing? Okay. Come here. Let me hit you. I do believe I can tank a few hits from you at this point in time. Blunt weapon and dodging. Good, 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 good. Very good. I would like to... Actually, that was the wrong spell to cast. Yeah, I wanted to cast heal. Why am I missing so much? My god. I guess it's because my agility isn't that high. But yeah, let us rest here until our... Yeah, health is full, and where are we right now? Let me just go ahead and check how much progress made to the next level, 46%. Yeah, this is also because of a mod, I forgot the name, but it's linked in, you know, Jewelars. I'm just gonna call them Jewelar for now. Jewelars, how do I put this, mod list. Okay, restoration has is seemingly improving. We need to cast it more often. It needs more casts to level up. That's for certain. And blunt weapon, again, it has leveled up probably. It just did level up, yes. Illusion, again, leveling up slowly. And medical. Resting to heal will help that, as will casting restoration spells. Mysticism, we have no spells there. Jumping, running, we can start running and jumping. And dodging will level up on its own. Short blade, that's because of, you know, that's an agility based thing, and blunt weapon is a strength based thing, probably why it sucks so bad, because plus one modifier, that's all I have, plus one, but then again, two hit is determined by agility, but even that is pretty low. Actually, I'm considered nimble, and I'm considered fairly strong, really a strong warrior. That is unheard of. Let us go ahead and see the game here. Yeah, the game lags initially after you load it up after like a save or something. It's like a temporary, short-term thing, but yeah, it's something that happens. So it's like this arrow shot from what the fuck. It's like this dungeon had put all its eggs into one basket. It still makes me sort of creeped out to explore dungeons in this game, even though I know that I'm exploring just these tiny ones that are inconsequential, to be honest, but still, holy shit, that is dark. Good thing standing in front of the lantern here. Look at the crossway. That's also because of a mod, by the way. Okay, the Graves of Vikum. 5 gold in a day. A crow calls in the distance. You smell freshly buried dead. That's the dungeon? Really? Interesting. I had not anticipated that. Maybe we need to light this up right now itself. Oh, there it is. I see. Right next to a marsh of all things. You can swim faster, go on. Hey, let's start running. Because we have not really been doing that. Let's start running and bunny hopping all over the place. To get our character like a faster level up boost. Alright. Once more onto the breach. Ooh, it's raining outside. Do you hear that sound? My god, that's amazing. So, my stealth is leveled up, meaning that there's a monster right nearby. It's probably that, Ooh, successful hit there. Are you gonna engage, or are you... Where the fuck are you running? Is it because I'm stronger than you? Most likely, yeah. Excuse me there. I just want to quickly check my save to see, yeah, I've not screwed myself over with that. It's been a long time since I've seen a human enemy. I do hope that... Well, human enemies are sort of like a double-edged sword. On one end, they give you some amazing loot, but on the other hand, they are also the reason that you die very quickly inside dungeons. Okay, any hidden doors or anything here? Just this, Yellowberry Sylvan, Asylum Ball, King Edward, Part 11. Now, my character is supposed to be intelligent, so he will most likely keep all the books that he gets. I'm guessing that's all there was in this dungeon. This soundtrack makes me really anxious, this particular one. But only a rat and a bat, no human enemies in this. Oh, let's run. Yeah, totally forgot about that. Whew, the rains. The rains. Totally makes like a world of difference. All these mods, they just... Ooh, make the game so immersive, I swear. Masterfield Cemetery, let's go. Alright, here we are. Of course I can jump over it. Because why would I be able to? I like the sound of the different textures. I mean, I think the original game had this as well. It wasn't just that pronounced, but... Look at the sound of running on grass versus running on the ground. Amazing, just amazing. Holy shit, this dungeon has a red mist. That's like... Just talking about trouble right off the bat. Enemies nearby. I hope it's not a human. Sometimes I hope it is a human, other times I hope it is not a human. That's just a rat. Alright. Let us eliminate you then. Did the other dungeon have a door here? I do not think it did, right? So I think the thing about... yeah, I don't know. I don't know if I want to save there or not. But I think the thing about Let me shock them to death instead. Since I do have the spell points for it currently. I think I might have hit the coffin there instead. Or the wall or something. Die, bitch. Half my strikes are missing. I guess that's just the... You're currently unwell, either due to disease or poisoning. Resting now may lead you to an early grave. Okay, yeah, that's another mod. I'm healthy, so actually I'm not healthy, to be honest right now. So what we can do here is resist poison. Let us try. Nope, we have caught a disease, so we planted that poison there. Yeah, I mean, it makes sense that we would catch a disease from rats, but here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to loot as much as I can from this place and then make a beeline for the entrance. No wonder this place was colored red. It might just be the death of me. Okay, so next order of business is to travel. Wait, let us turn off the torch first. Let us travel to... Yeah, towns. Let us turn on towns and travel to one with a temple. Actually, rather, yeah, let's do this. We're here, right? Masterfield Cemetery? I think so. And this should be the Blessed Tree of Kynareath. Alright, let us go there. You're not well and may not survive an extended period of travel. Do you still wish to continue with the fast travel? Yes. You feel somewhat bad, you feel somewhat bad. You're entering the Blessed Tree of Kynareath. 7-11. Brain fever. Willpower, your health, even your personality trickle away day by day. You must either get a cure or face oblivion. You've contracted the plague, a very serious, often fatal disease. Very quickly it spread through your system. Few who contracted it live for more than a few days unless they're cured quickly. Cool then. Good thing that the temple was only a stone's throw away. And this is why you need spells or potions in this game. Kind temple. Please, please, oh please, heal me. No. Can you like... Yeah, cure disease, thank you. You have bargained me long and hard, strange, but let us be done. I would normally charge more, but for you, I only ask 656 gold for curing me. Are you serious? Holy hell. It's a ripoff. I lost all the... I literally lost all the damn... This temple definitely looks different from the House of Dibella. Much less nudity. Kind. Okay, so with that having been done, let us go ahead and save it here and save too. We should be healthier now. Yes, good. It's a bloody ripoff. How much gold did I lose with that? 2099. So basically, my whatever gold I got from the last few dungeons has been useless, essentially. That's what happened. So I was here, Masterfield Cemetery, or was I here, Graves of Wickham? I honestly don't know, but at this point I don't really care if I... Actually, I think I was here. Could have been here. Who knows? But at any rate, we have already cleared these two out, Graves of Buckingham and the Buckingham Cemetery. We probably have cleared this one out as well. And it doesn't really hurt to check, to be honest. We could have just been here, Graves of Wickham. I've lost track at this point. At any rate, let us go here and start clearing out these dungeons right here. These, by the way, are Witch Guns, Sage Monument, and Reliquary of Psy. These are all Witch Guns. Tombs of Hurdston. You smell freshly turned earth, you smell freshly buried dead. I wonder what the smell of freshly buried dead is. Oh yeah, run. Because of the color boost, things might appear a little too bright from time to time. But without the color boost, I can hardly see a thing in this game. There's even like a house here. But typically these houses don't really have anything of value. Alright, Tombs of Hurdston. Light on, and... pre-dungeon save. Come on then. Let us go ahead and enter the space. Again, red. Eight hours of sleep. Yep. That was a trap. It has like this chance to hurt you. It won't always hurt you, but it does have this certain chance of hurting you. I see a rat. Typically, there. Yeah, so this is similar to that one dungeon module that I confused the previous one with. I wonder if it's a level thing, but I don't think it is. Okay, let us save the game here. Even though it was just a rat, but so. Like, saving is always good practice. It doesn't matter how many times you save or why you save. Short tunic. Interesting. Holy hell, the door hadn't even opened yet. Look at this guy hitting, my god. Are you like... This guy must have been... Like... Marked as something else, because... Holy hell, how the hell does something hit that hard? Like a bat? I can't believe that a bat can ever hit that hard. Seems totally inconceivable to my little brain. Okay, time to turn the torch off and head to next one. Yeah, Yomston Graveyard, and then here, then here, then here, then here. Then we go here. No, we've already been there. Here and finally here. Fine. Yomston Graveyard. Let's go. Our magic points were full, but since we are traveling cautiously, we lost them. The grass sounds sort of wet. I like that. Alright. Saving in the pre-dungeon save. Turning that on. And let us rest. Good thing that we can rest here. Not really an option in a lot of dungeons. Our blunt weapon is definitely improving, so that's for certain. What the fuck just happened there? Yeah, this game still does use billboard sprites, doesn't it? I wonder if anybody could make like a 3D mod for this game to flesh out all the characters in 3D instead of having them be like 2D billboard sprites. I mean, with Unity, it most certainly should be possible. Thus far, I've only found just one mod with, sorry, one dungeon with a hidden wall. Maybe this dungeon also has one. Who knows? You know what? Let me shock you. Thank you. leather right pauldron. Do we have that? I think we do. Yeah, this entire thing is considered chain pauldron, not just for the arms. Because Arena had like those braces as well. This game does not have it. So Arena had like far more pieces of armor. If required, we could probably use a buckler as well. At any rate, ivory formal tunic. Any hidden doors here? Just this thing on the wall. 60 gold pieces, and we have not. Basilisk's eye. We can get like quite a few things from these dungeons. Alright, next one then. It's a dark, dark night. Yeah, this dungeon, this cemetery doesn't really have anything in front of it either. Look at all the stars in the sky. Whew. Beautiful, just beautiful. Alright, enough sightseeing, on to the Ashheart Tombs. That's what it is. The Ashheart Tombs. It's a cloudy, overcast day. Entrance should be somewhere over here. If memory serves me right, which it usually does. I bound the mute button to control them, so sometimes you might see the mic pop up randomly when I'm trying to mute the game. Holy shit, I did actually fit through those doors. Really interesting. Alright. Pre-dungeon save. Whoops, right here. We can actually rest here. That's... Previous few dungeons have been kind to us, but at the same time... They've also been the kind of dungeons that... haven't really yielded much in the name of loot. What happened? Like, should I not have the spell points to do that, or... Was it just missing the rat? Because I can't figure out why I kept missing him with the spell. Hidden door. Let's save you, in case there's something objectionable within. Okay, that is certainly objectionable. It's a goddamn torture room. What kind of family builds a goddamn torture room inside of a dungeon? I hear something in there. Ah, a rat. The rat is dead. I see a hidden door right off the bat. Right here. Or not. Yeah, guess it was just my imagination. I did let it run wild. Yellow flowers, southern yellow flowers. Alright, let's move on. I love the sound of rain. Especially when indoors. And this mod, ambient dungeons mod, really fixes the entire feel of that for me. Alright, fixing tombs. It's like every family gets a tomb. So it's so dark that the sun isn't shining through, but my mana points aren't really regenerating either. I guess it has more to do with the... the time of day rather than the actual fact about whether you're receiving sunlight or not. Again, this one was open, which is quite surprising. Oh, there it is. This is it? Yes, this is. Holy shit, that scared me. So, our running has leveled up, which is good. Alright, let us rest listening to the sound of rain against the backdrop. Okay, we need to... Holy shit, should have run instead. Okay, let's rest again. And equip this because there's a woman right up ahead that we need to eliminate. I'm gonna grab the buckler for good measure. She can somehow see me. Oh! The shock spell actually came through. That's really nice. We've got a buckler, a helm, and leather boots. Destruction and stealth. That's pretty good, pretty good. Helm, +3, +3. Good thing that helm isn't actually considered a part of... Holy shit, two of them. This dungeon is like full of humans. Okay, so it's definitely not a range issue, it's probably like an RNG issue. Okay, I need to run. Rest outside. Thank the Lord for the persistent dungeon mod. Okay, we're going back in. Rather, this demon than the other one. My torch flickers and dies, apparently. Okay, gold pieces, iron warhammer, helm, steel, leather cuirass, chain greaves. chain greaves definitely sounds nice. We can't really wear the rest. We already do have a better cuirass than that. Whoops. Until fully healed, yes, thank you. And let us go ahead and save you. Because holy hell, that was a fight. That was most definitely a fight. This is plus 3 again, so let us go ahead and remove this. But this thing, we can definitely equip this. What do you have? Leather baldron, leather cuirass, leather greaves, leather boots, nothing else. Buckler, steel longsword, buckler, leather boots, alright. 3 thieves and 1 thief. Let us go ahead and put this in slot number 7. Let's hope there are no more thieves in this base. No more grave robbers, but I mean, honestly, grave robbers give you the most. Let's go ahead and update the save again, because I just feel like it. I am venting. Give you the best loot, to be honest. This is floating in the air again. Cactus. Rare ingredients, especially in these parts of the Illiac Bay. This dungeon gave us like a worthwhile fight. I'm glad for that. Nope. Okay, why don't you die, son? Let's hope that we can survive this encounter. We did! That's really nice. A helm, steel right baldron, iron left baldron, leather cuirass, leather greaves, leather boots. That's it. That scared me. Rightfully so. Actually, I'll just heal while traveling instead, if you don't mind. Let's turn that off to preserve it. And let's go to the Master's Bed Vault. We're pretty much near the end of this thing here. Slightly richer than we were before. Which is a fact that I really like. I'll just stick to these things for now. That was a pretty chilling cry out there. And I guess made even chillier by the fact that we're using ambient dungeons. Alright. Let us go ahead and save here. And enter. Enemies nearby, alright. I should probably not rest with the torch on. Yeah, I'm missing. I'm definitely missing. Alright, let's rest here until... should have turned the torch off actually. It's life is slowly fading away. I do believe we could have like... I installed this mod that lets me turn lights on and off inside dungeons. I think it was called Darker Dungeons, but it somehow is not working. Or maybe I just don't know how to use it properly. But yeah. Basically that's what's happening. Yeah, this thing is confused because I'm not right directly in front of it. Yeah, these spells really do have like a very long reach. It's not really a reach issue as much as it is just an issue of the chance to hit. Oh, right. You should rest on what you've learned about backstabbing. Why does that sound like an insult? Let's keep casting this while we can. Alright, let's turn this off, and we are traveling next to the Vixley Tombs, which is right on the border. I wonder if we can walk over to the other side. That would be insane. We have been here, yes, 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 we have covered the Corpus Lee Graveyard. Just 3 more remaining after this one. Like, once we cover this, there will be only 2 more remaining. I've become a better backstabber, is what the game tells me. That seems to be the entrance right there, so let us go right for it. Let us not stand around outside idly by and dilly-dally. I can't believe that guy was actually waiting for me outside. That thief or whatever it was. in the middle of the night that came to assault me. He came in the morning, but he was literally just standing about outside. Alright, let's save here. Let us enter without the torch on, and okay, we can't rest, so might as well move on ahead. That hurt us. Just a little bit. We can... Wait. Yeah, no, let us rest now. Yeah, makes sense. Just to preserve the torch, you know. Since we have done all that, let's just go ahead and save. Okay, a bat. One hit kill, let's go. Yeah, the only problem with using this... that thing... oh, okay, I'm equipping that. And we might as well keep that in the... wagon, mummy wrappings. I remember this quest. I don't know whether it was Mage's Guild or something else, but yeah, there's this quest where you need to go and find some mummy wrappings. Let me shock you to death instead. How am I... how do I suck so bad at hitting people with spells? I need to create like a custom spell just for shocking other beings. And essentially practice it all every single chance that I get. It's the middle of the night, let us go ahead and fast travel to the second last dungeon, the penultimate dungeon of this quest, Woodwing Graveyard. A wagon rut leads off a ways, a low ghostly moon shivers by. That is not bode well. Makes it sound like a... a place with ghosts inside. Like, even near the end of the end of a warrior playthrough, ghosts were incredibly difficult because they could just paralyze me, and I had to... they were like a bane on my resources, to be honest. I'm not certain that I could actually take on ghosts as a mage in this run through. Not right now, I mean. Later, definitely, yes. Just give me a moment there. Let us rest. Good thing that we can rest. This should make torches last longer. Doing things this way, I mean. We are blending, which is amazing news. Not every day that you can blend. Oh, I know I hit him. Leather boots, steel saber, round shield, maybe. For now. Leather greaves, leather boots. Yeah, everything is leather. Let us retreat up there for a bit. Actually, let me turn this off before resting. Until I'm fully healed, I mean. Cool. And with that being done, let us go ahead and update the savior. Alright. Turn on again, and... yeah, let's check these out. This helm is probably nothing good. Yeah, just plus 3 to armor rating, we could definitely sell it off. This, however, will increase our defenses by a certain margin, making it a little more difficult to hit us. Challenger strap. And, well, illusion, hey? Good thing that it finally got upgraded. My illusion skill, I mean. Another good thing about Daggerfall Unity is that the loot is persistent. By default, the loot is persistent. Meaning that if you were to... there's a rat behind this door, that is for certain. Let me shock you. Any other bats here? One more. Ooh, that was a one-hit kill. Nothing to make you feel more powerful than a damn one-hit kill. Alright. We're out of here. Let us access a wagon for a brief moment here and remove some of the stuff that we are not using into it. Even though I'm mage, I'm confined to playing this game like a... We can probably keep these in the wagon as well. Don't really need it for the time being. Arrow shot woman, what is it? By Anonymous, 580 gold. The Asylum Ball by Vaughanshot. And King Edward, part 11. Okay. The arrow shot for me. Yeah, none of these are skill books. So I've installed this mod, which that's a formal tunic, all right. Challenger straps, huh? I wonder. Okay, that just makes me mute. No point in wearing them. Those are priest robes. Okay, we could antique surcoat. Let's keep most of our stuff in the wagons. Bring them out as necessary, keep this area as clutter-free as possible. Look at that, Marcel and Secunda together. We took a screenshot. I don't know whether we did or not, so I'm just gonna print screen. Okay, last dungeon, Vixley Graveyard. I mean, I wouldn't mind if this challenge, if this dungeon was a challenge either way. So, here we go. Running and jumping just to passively increase our skills. I prefer keeping like the minor skills, something that we can easily upgrade passively, like this. So, alright, time to save here. Can we rest here? Nope, enemies nearby. Alright, let's turn this on then. And we got a boo-boo. Because that thing was a bitch. Doesn't let us rest. This thing is a godsend. Learn about the shot there, good. That has upgraded as well, our shot there, I mean. I feel like I probably should have saved there while I had the chance. But no reason why we can't rest and save here either. Actually, yeah. Thank you. We keep forgetting about that. I'll probably start remembering it as time goes by. For now, I would just like to update this here save. And yeah, we should be good. Vixley Graveyard. I'm a common citizen who reads graves. That's all I do, just read graves. I don't even have the mana to like cast a spell and hit people. Gorgon snake, small scorpion stinger, and that's it. Nothing else, literally nothing else in here. Alright, that pretty much brings us to the end of our dungeon raiding days. I do not wish to stay here though. Let me get rid of that and put this away. Okay, that's a chilling scream. Sounds like it's time to head back to Daggerfall now. All the way there, my god. So, this being persistent dungeons means that we will not be able to... If we want to get richer or something, we'll have to look into other provinces for that. Bulletin board, it's just a Daggerfall, so I guess their enmity with Koekria has ceased, which is sort of a good sign. Everything is bright, everything is shiny. So where am I headed again? That's a really good question. At any rate, thank you guys so much for tuning in, thank you guys so much for sticking around until the end. And yeah, the next time we come back, we'll perhaps try and figure something else out to, you know, maybe complete a few quests for the locals, like delivery quests and things of that nature, until we can level up and essentially purchase spells and get some like worthwhile gear. Maybe the next video will be about spell making, who knows. I might be able to sell some of the stuff that I have, but like most of the stuff actually. Oh wait. Let's go ahead and put all the stuff into the wagon, because we definitely do not need it all the way out here. Ivory. Cool. We are still, we like 42 kilograms, so that's something. Why are we carrying around like a 400 kilogram cart? We should be... Yeah, we can't remove that into the wagon, I wonder why. At any rate, yeah. So we should have like a pretty decent haul that we can sell off. And combined with the haul, the money that we will... and combining the money that we will get alongside that, we should be able to... Well... If not level up, then at least... get somewhere, you know, where we can purchase better gear and better spells, essentially. So... that's the idea. That is the grand idea. And with that being said, I will see you next time. Until then. Ooh, is that a pool there? Interesting. With rush and everything. Take care. Fare thee well, fellow things.